Tensions have reached boiling point in a far north Queensland community following the fatal police shooting of an Aboriginal man. Officers say he lunged at them with a knife during a tense standoff. The actions of police are tonight under investigation. And Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander viewers are warned this story contains images of a person who has died.
On the streets of Mareeba, a mix of anguish and anger as a community sees red at a force in blue. Unrest and frustration over the fatal police shooting of Aboriginal man Aubrey Donoghue. His family has given us permission to use these photos.
Can't honestly believe it. Never thought something like this would happen.
The 27-year-old's family and friends are inconsolable. His mother, devastated.
My son is loving, caring and always thought about his siblings and his mum.
Police say they were called to the Love Street address just before lunch yesterday after reports he had threatened self-harm. They say he had a woman with him and refused to let her leave the home. Then, after a four-hour standoff, specialist officers say he advanced at them with a knife. That's when he was fatally shot. A friend of Donoghue was on the phone to him at the time and claims he was willing to surrender.
What was best practice for them, for the Queensland Police Service, QPS? Why did they have to shoot him?
It will be inappropriate for me to provide comments in relation to that investigation today.
That's because the fatal shooting is now the subject of an ethical standards probe on behalf of the coroner. Investigators arrived at the home this morning.
To ensure that it's independent, transparent and provides answers for the man's family.
An emergency town meeting with one of the Far North's top cops did little to quell tensions. As police left, they copped a barrage of rocks and abuse as a community latches on to a new catch cry.
Justice for Aubrey!
In their fight for answers. Garth Burley, 7 News.